Facebook and YouTube. I'm Laura and I will be your host today. I'm from Mexico, so this will be all Mexican Spanish. Okay? Thank you for joining us. I will be checking your comments. If you have any good example or if you have a question, I can answer to you right now if it's a really good example. If not, I will come back to you later. After this lesson, I will answer your questions and I will give you feedback about your examples you are giving, okay? Okay, today's topic is poder and no poder, can and can't, to express what you can do and what can't you do in Spanish, okay? Thank you for joining. How are you, everyone? Nandi, Otto, a lot of people joining, thank you. Before we start the lesson, I want to tell you that we have a present for you. If you click on the description below on YouTube or in the description above on Facebook, you can have access to free material, cheat sheets. You can use anytime. There is really, really useful stuff here. We have, for example, this one, dining like a champ. If you can have a look, you can just download it, have it in your iPad or phone, or you can print it out if you want, and then go to a restaurant, a Spanish-speaking restaurant. You can just start speaking Spanish right away. Just read it. For example, ¿qué me recomienda? What do you recommend? And then you have here vocabulary in case they recommend you something. You can also say, can you give me the, me puede dar la cuenta, por favor? Give me the check, please. So you don't even need to know Spanish to start practicing, okay? So make sure to take advantage of them, print them all out or download them, and let's begin, okay? So today's topic, can and can't. Let's begin with an example. Imagine you are in Mexico City and someone approaches you and says, ¿puedes ayudarme? If you know the person, you might want to say yes. Sí. Yo puedo ayudarte. Yes. I can help you. If it's someone you don't know, you better say, no, yo no puedo ayudarte. No, I cannot help you. Okay? So as you can see, the verb poder, no poder, is conjugated. Yo puedo. Yo no puedo. As you may know, in Spanish, all verbs are conjugated, depending on the subject. We have the Spanish subject pronouns. Yo, I, tú, yo. Usted, you in the formal register, él, ella, he, she, nosotros, we, ustedes, they, ustedes is you all, ellos, ellas, they, ellos is for male, ellas for female, and let's see how to conjugate the verb poder with all these subject pronouns, okay? So, yo puedo. I can. Tú puedes. You can. Usted, él, ella puede. You, he, she, I can. Nosotros podemos. We can. Ustedes, ellos, ellas pueden. You all, they can. Okay? Really simple. This is an irregular verb, so you need to memorize the conjugation forms. This is conjugated in the present tense, okay? So, in order to say you cannot, you just need to add the no before the verb. Yo no puedo. People on Instagram, I'm so sorry you cannot see the whiteboard. If you want to access to the full whiteboard, you need to access from YouTube or Facebook. Also there we have the cheat sheets for you. Please move on to the other side. Okay, thank you. And let's continue. So, as I was saying, in order to form the negative, You just need to add the no before the verb. Yo no puedo, tú no puedes, usted no puede, etc. Okay? So let's see some examples. Yo puedo hablar español. I can speak Spanish. Yo no puedo escribir japonés. I cannot write Japanese. Okay? If you have a good example, let me see them. Hola a todos. Buenas noches. Buenos días, buenas tardes. We have Kyle. Yo no puedo andar en bicicleta. He cannot ride a bicycle. Good example, Kyle. Perfect. And thank you everyone for posting. Okay, so let's continue. Let's see more examples. Él, let's see with a different subject pronoun. Él puede escribir cartas. He can write letters. Ella no puede nadar. She cannot swim. Okay? So from these examples, you can identify the sentence pattern to form this type of sentences with the verb poder. We have the subject. It doesn't have to be a subject pronoun, of course. You can just change it to different type of subject, a proper noun, for example. Pedro cannot speak English. Pedro no puede hablar inglés, okay? Or could be a phrase, los niños pequeños no pueden nadar. Small children cannot swim. So any type of subject. So the subject, and then we have the verb poder conjugated, remember, conjugated. And then we have the verb in infinitive form. The second verb is always in infinitive form. After that, you can add any kind of complement. Could be a noun, an adverb, a phrase. Okay, and then to form the negative, you just add the no. Subject plus no plus verb poder conjugated plus verb in infinitive. Complement, everything else, additional information. And so that's the basic sentence pattern, okay? That's very simple. And now let's go back to our first example we have here. Sí, yo puedo ayudarte. Yes, I can help. And then we have the te. What's that te? That's the direct object pronoun. If you are directing this action to someone directly, then you need to add this direct object pronoun always, okay? Remember that. So direct object pronoun is a whole different topic, a bit complicated for some, but we can have a lesson later on. Now just remember, you have to use it if you're, what you can do is directed to someone, is affecting someone directly, okay? Okay, so to form those type of examples, those kind of sentences affecting someone, then you need to change the sentence pattern a bit. You have the subject, you have the verb poder conjugated, you have the verb in infinitive, and you have to attach the direct object pronoun, okay? And then, if for to form the negative, just the same, just add the no, subject plus no, plus verb poder conjugated, plus verb in infinitive, attach direct object pronoun. Are we good so far? You have any question? Oh, I'm glad, Arturo, you can understand. It's just a matter of practicing. Okay. Good. We have people from Japan watching. Okay. So let's continue. Yes, we have that sentence pattern we can follow, but we have one more choice. If you want to emphasize that you are doing something just because that's the person you are doing it for. For example, yo te puedo ayudar. You are emphasizing that you are helping because it's that person, okay? So you can just move the direct object pronoun before the verb. Yo te puedo ayudar means the same. I can help you, but you are emphasizing. Yo no te puedo ayudar. I cannot help you. The only change you made was moving the direct object pronoun just before the verb. So subject, direct object pronoun, verb poder conjugated, plus verb in infinitive, and everything else, additional information. Okay? Subject, no, direct object pronoun, verb poder conjugated, verb in infinitive. Okay? Let's see. Oh, Kyle. Oh, yes, Kyle. This is Mexican Spanish. So, if people in Spain might conjugate different the some of these pronouns. So, they have like vosotros and different type of things, pronouns. Also, people in Argentina, they have vos instead. So, I'm not really familiar with those dialects. Everything here is now in Mexican Spanish. I hope you are enjoying it and it's useful. Oh, Cody, you don't understand the difference between the dialects, Mexican Spanish, Spain Spanish. Basically, it's the same. I mean, all Spanish speakers can understand each other. Just some verbs are conjugated a bit different. Hello, Orly. So instead of having usted, they have a different pronoun. They don't use usted for the meaning you. So I might be giving you incorrect information if I continue explaining about Iberian Spanish or any other dialect. I can only focus on Mexican Spanish. I'm sorry. But if you have any question about the Iberian Spanish, post it in the comments. And I will have someone that speak that dialect answer to you. All right? Okay. Okay. So let's continue. Valentine's Day is approaching, right? So what if someone asks you out? They say, ¿Puedo verte el sábado? Can I see you on Saturday? And you can use your sentence pattern you just learned. Let's see. You can say, yes. You can see me on Saturday. Tú puedes verme el sábado. Or you can say, no, tú no puedes verme el sábado. No, you cannot see me on Saturday. Okay? As you can see, since the action, the poder action, is directed to me, then the direct object pronoun is me instead of te. Te means to you. Me, to me. All right? So, remember to download the useful cheat sheets you have here. You can just, for example, go to the one about leisure time and activities and check the verbs. You have a lot of verbs here and activities. So you can say, practice your pattern. You can say, I can go shopping. I can go shopping today. Yo puedo ir de compras hoy. Or you can say, play an instrument. This is the vocabulary phrase here. So you can say, yo puedo tocar un instrumento. Or yo no puedo tocar un instrumento. So just select any cheat sheet and just practice. Because this is really simple. It's just a matter of practicing. If you know the pattern, you can just apply it to anything. Okay? You can just express what you can do or what you cannot do anytime. So if you want, you can print out the screen to have those sentence patterns. Or if you want to go old school, you can just write it down. And this is the main thing you need to know, you know, the sentence patterns to form the sentences with the verb poder or no poder in Spanish. Okay? Oh, I'm glad some people say they need Mexican Spanish, so I'm glad. And hello, Marruecos. Let's see. So we have people from many countries, people on Facebook. Lawrence, it's just a matter of practicing. And if you can learn like this, for example, one pattern at a time, how to express a specific idea, then you can just build it up. And with these cheat sheets, you can just start practicing right away. Just go to a Spanish-speaking restaurant, store, or to your Spanish-speaking friends, and just practice. If you don't need to memorize it, you can just read it at the beginning, and if you practice, it's gonna stick in your head, okay? Muy bien, AJ. Yo puedo comer el desayuno ahora. Perfect. Buen provecho. Let me see. More examples. Don't be shy. Share your examples. As I said, it's just a matter of practicing. If you keep just try, even if you make mistakes at the beginning, nobody will mind. I mean, everyone makes mistakes. So just try, okay? Hola. España. 99 España. Me encanta el español. Oh, I'm glad you think this easy. Okay, so let's see a bit more examples. Now let's see how to form questions. We saw questions here, right? So, ¿puedes ayudarme? You have the verb poder, and then the verb in infinitive form, and then you have here the direct object pronoun, and you need to make the question, right? The intonation. So, ¿puedes ayudarme? You can also make a question about something in general without directing the activity to someone directly. For example, ¿puedes andar en bicicleta? Can you ride a bicycle? So it's puedes, the verb poder, conjugated always, and then the verb in infinitive form, and then everything else, the additional information, adverb, adjective, phrase. Do you guys have any question with puedes? Try it out. Hello, Fabiano. I'm glad you are trying to learn Spanish. And Jai, it's not easy. Do you have any specific question? What's the difficult part about this? We can go back to anything you need to practice. Teresa, yes, slowly. It's good to learn. Just keep building up the knowledge. It doesn't matter if we learn fast or slow. We can just take our time and enjoy it. Because that's the main part. If you enjoy something, you want to keep doing it. If you stress out and just want to learn all the grammar together in one week or something for the exam, doesn't work. You just need to enjoy it, practice it. If you can see that you can apply it right away, you will feel more motivated, right? That's why these cheat sheets are really useful, because you can just apply them after you download them. And then you feel like, oh, I'm speaking Spanish. So you feel motivated to keep learning, right? Oh, poder, Jai. Poder. Poder. Do you want to go back to the conjugation? Puedo. Puedes. Puede. Podemos, pueden, poder, that means can, yay. Okay, you're welcome. And let's see. Muy bien, Hanin, yo puedo verte ahora. That's perfect. And you are even using the direct object pronoun in that sentence. So, really good. That means, I can see you now. Okay, so, perfect, 99 España. ¿Le puedo ayudar? Can I help you? Te puedo ayudar. You need to, if you add the direct object pronoun at the beginning, you just need to say, te puedo ayudar. You omit the te at the end. You just need the direct object pronoun once, either. Te puedo ayudar o puedo ayudarte. Okay? Poder in infinitive. Someone is asking KMO. 3 to 5 is asking, when will you use poder in infinitive form? It might be occasions. Just think about in English. When will you say can in infinitive form? Yeah, in English it's always. So let's see. Poder. No creo poder ir hoy. I don't think I can go today. So usually when the verb poder is the second verb, you will use in different type of formations, sentence formations, you will use a verb first and then poder in infinitive form. So you can use it in infinitive form, but it's not that common. Usually used in conjugated form. Because you say I can, to say I can do something is always conjugated. So in this kind of sentence formation, always conjugated, okay? So we have here Kyle. Yo no puedo contar hasta cinco. I cannot count till five. Bueno, Kyle, hay que estudiar los números en español. We need to study the numbers in Spanish. But the example is really good. I think you can, because if you can make that type of example, that means you already know. Okay, so let's see. So, regarding forming questions with poder, is it clear already? Okay, so let's see. Let's practice. Let's take our cheat sheet and let's see, for example. We have one about giving directions. That's very useful. If you are in a cab and then you don't know how to give directions to the cab, you know the address you want to go to, but like if they don't know, you can say, de vuelta a la izquierda, turn left, go straight, vaya derecho. So it really, really useful. Puedes preguntar usando nuestra estructura, using our structure from today. ¿Puede llevarme a esta dirección? Can you take me to this address? ¿Puede llevarme a esta dirección? And you show them the GPS in your phone. So that's another example of how can we use the verb poder. It's very useful, right? Okay, you guys are socializing, that's good, because if you make friends that want have the same objective, then you guys can good. And then you guys just can practice together, maybe have some meetings and practice and motivate each other. Okay, so let's continue. So as you can see, you can use poder for many things, right? And this is very useful. So let's see. Puedes dar la vuelta a la izquierda. Can you turn left? Another example. ¿Me puede llevar a este lugar? Can you take me to this place? It's rephrasing the different example I have already gave. And ¿puedo ir a un concierto? Asking your parents for permission. ¿Puedo ir a un concierto? Can I go to a concert? If you are not feeling like going out, ¿puedo quedarme en casa? Can I stay home? ¿Puedo quedarme en casa? The action is directed toward me. ¿Podemos viajar? If you ask your partner, ¿podemos viajar a México? Can we travel to Mexico? Podemos, direct object pronoun for we. Podemos viajar a México. Okay. ¿Cómo se dice? Can you teach them? How do you say can you teach them? ¿Puedes enseñarles? Direct object pronoun for them is les. Enseñarles. ¿Puedes enseñarles? Oh, Hanin, another example. Yo puedo verte ahora. That's perfect. Ah, España. ¿Puedes mostrarme dónde está el banco? That's really good. Can you show me where is the bank? Just remember that mostrarme goes together. If you are, let's see here. Remember that if the direct object pronoun goes right after the verb in infinitive, it goes together. Mostrarme, forming one word as a suffix, okay? And if you move the direct object pronoun before the verb, it goes separate. So it's me muestra. Me muestra dónde está el banco, okay? So together and as a different word, all right? Okay. So let's see. So we saw already some help for you to reject or accept a date, right? For next week, Valentine's Day. But we will be teaching you more useful phrases and words next week. Rosa is going to be here and she is going to tell you dating phrases, dating how to ask someone to go out or many things, okay? So don't miss it. And as I said, make sure to download all this because it's very useful. You can practice anything with this and you can start using your Spanish right away, all right? Thank you everyone for watching and we will see you next week, all right? Bye-bye, thank you. Bye-bye.